I told myself I was done with your jacket ready with get ready with me's because I filmed a million of them. Hate all of them. I'm like, why did you say that? No one cares. But here we are. So there's a few things that are different. Obviously, the spot in which you're seeing is different. Mainly for the reason that I just rearranged this, or I haven't moved or anything like that. That nothing crazy is happening to me. I have a surgery tomorrow. I'm having my implant done, for those who don't know. I don't know if you've seen my first makeup tutorial, but I didn't have a tooth. This is a fake tooth. It's a retainer. I was born without a tooth. It's so exciting and such a fun story to tell. That's what's happening tomorrow. I'm really nervous about it because I've had a bone graft done. If you don't know what a bone graft is, it's just basically where they took bone from my chin and put it into the place where they're putting the implant. And I'm not gonna lie to you, boss, that fucking sucked. It was probably one of the worst things ever. I had a black eye. It was awful. I was in so much pain for so many days. I know that this implant surgery is not gonna be anywhere near as bad as that, because, like, it's not. They're not taking bone out of my freaking head, but, you know, you get it. My boyfriend's in Ukraine, and we have a 10-hour difference, and when I'm going to bed, he's waking up, so I always like to do my makeup at night so that I can look pretty for him. Oh my god, you're pretty without makeup! Shut up, I know. But thank you. Lately, I've been loving Huda Beauty's Faux Filter Foundation. I also really like Estee Lauder's 1C1. Mixed together, they create a good skin tone for me. Still a little too red though. This is a little too dark for me still. In my first video, I used Estee Lauder 1N1 Ivory Nude. If you can see, there's a little bit of a difference. This one's a little lighter. And I used Jouer for a while in Pearl, but apparently Jouer has a lighter shade than Pearl, and this is too dark. I should have gotten Pearl. I thought, like, oh, it's gonna be too light. It was not. And then Clinique's lighter shade is too dark. So the only foundation I have right now that matches my skin tone is this one and Lancôme's. And Lancôme is just not full coverage enough for me, because I don't know if you look at my skin right now, but it's a mess. It's so bad. So we'll probably just end up going with my Tarte Shape Tape, which also matches my skin tone pretty well. I just don't love it. I'm a junior next year. Woo! Hell yeah! I'm going to a new school where I know nobody. I was homeschooled last semester, and I could have gone back to the school I went to before I started homeschooling. However, it's a really big school, and it's a lot of walking, and I'm just not down. End of story. I've been saying that lately because a lot of people, my boyfriend tells me that I'm like really bad at telling stories, so I've had to like start telling people, like, that's it. It's not funny. I'm not telling you a story. I'm telling you a fact. This happened to me today. End of story. That's it. It's done. I'm not trying to be funny. I'm literally telling you something. I was supposed to write a paper like 6 days ago. I still haven't written it. And then I was reading a book, and I was like so into the book, like, wow. And then like I was just like, well, you know, book or Netflix? And I chose Netflix. And then I finished every show I was watching on Netflix. And now I could be like, book or YouTube? And I have nothing to watch on YouTube, so I've just kind of fallen down this dark hole of Dr. Phil. And like today at the dinner table, I was like watching Dr. Phil, and my mom's like, who are you watching? And I was like, Daddy Phil. And she's like, why? And I was like, for the storyline? Shout out to the girl who blocked me on Instagram and then told me she's gonna block me before she blocked me. I don't even know you. Thanks. She was like, damn, you're cute. Too bad I gotta block you. Apparently I said something offensive. Really? Like, why did you tell me you were gonna block me before you blocked me? Like, you could've just blocked me. Girls be like, oh God, I have so many cuts in my mouth because I've been so hungry lately that when I eat, I'm like so into chewing that I just cut open my mouth and I don't even stop to be like, ow. I just keep going. I cut through the cuts. It's been bad. I have got 3 cuts going on from eating a burger yesterday, and I didn't even finish the burger. My boyfriend brought up a really cool topic the other day that I wanted to talk about. So, a lot of guys, when I was like younger mostly, would like really comment on the fact that I wore a lot of makeup and that I was ugly because I wore a lot of makeup. Like, somehow in their mind, they're like, there is a correlation. And that was just like really annoying because, I mean, I've never worn makeup to make myself feel better, not ever. I've literally always worn makeup. I've worn makeup since I was 8, before there was even Instagram. Like, for the reason that I just loved doing it, it was just so much fun. I would do it with my friends and stuff. I don't know, I just had a good time, right? So this being said, a lot of guys were like, when I was younger, were like, oh, you wear so much makeup, you'd be so much prettier if you didn't wear makeup. Or I'd have like teachers come up to me and be like, you realize you don't have to wear that much makeup? And I'd be like, fuck yeah. Like, shit, dude, get out of my vagina. So then one day, my boyfriend, I was like pretty insecure about it. Like, I was feeling weird because somebody said I wore too much makeup, like probably a girl. And my boyfriend's like, putting effort into your look doesn't make you ugly. And I was like, wow, that is a quote, dude. It actually makes you more attractive because you actually give a shit about your appearance. So I don't know, if you're feeling insecure because you wear a lot of makeup and like a boy just came up to you and was like, you're ugly because you wear a lot of makeup, and wearing a lot of makeup equals you're insecure and ugly underneath, you can just be like,
haha, I actually just care. And you are gay.
So I might just get like really inherently quiet, or I might just talk through the entire thing and mess with my eyebrows. It's funny, I usually get really quiet when I bake and then talk a bunch while I'm doing my eyebrows. I'm like, I literally am just patting powder in my face. I don't understand why I'm so focused. So I've been really into like listening to music from my old days right now. Listening to Selena Gomez and The Scene. I don't know if y'all remember, that was like her first band. And honestly, if I'm about to spill some tea right now, Selena Gomez and The Scene was a million times better than the music she's putting out right now. I don't know if you've heard like Dilemma or Middle of Nowhere or Love Song. Who hasn't heard Love Song? Like, it was her and pretty much every single song from the Lemonade Mouth soundtrack that I was just like, I would go down to my grandmother's basement
and just blast it. And the whole time I was like afraid I was gonna get like raped by like a shadow monster man.
I didn't care because Lemonade Mouth was inspiring me to be a better person. I was determinating. I also really want to get like a frame for my room. Like they have these things at like Hobby Lobby that are like, it's like a frame, like, and all they're mixed one and it looks really rustic and cute. And I want to get it and like put a bunch of pictures of like me and my friends in it, me and my boyfriend, me and my mom and dad, stuff like that. But my mom today, I was at Hobby Lobby and I was like, about to cop it. And my mom's like, no. And I was like, why? And she's like, because you can't always get what you want. And today I learned a very severe life lesson. I don't know why she decided to tell me that like today. It wasn't even that expensive. I was just like, what? My eyebrows are coming out bad today. Beauty guru, more like beauty boohoo. Yes, we love to look bad, but it's okay because we're gonna try something today. Because today, me and my mom went to Ulta, got some brow tint that was actually in my shade, because I have this brow tint in blonde whenever I used to do my eyebrows lighter. But as you can tell, I'm not really about making my eyebrows light anymore, so I had to get it in chocolate. Hell yeah! I just needed something to make the girls stand up. Eyebrow tints are the push-up bra of
eyebrows?
We're gonna call that a day on the eyebrows and just move forward. Even though I literally can never, ever, ever do my eyeliner right on camera. I'm very good at eyeliner. Don't mean to toot my own horn, but I'm a toot. And whenever I'm on camera, the minute I take out my eyeliner, and put it against my eye, it ends up down here. And I'm like, what?
Ghost car on camera?
So, this is the fun part! I got the Thirsty palette the other day. Let me just say, if you are thinking about buying it, Yes, do it. It's an amazing palette. I'm having a blast with it. I really recommend it, actually. It's super blendable. The metallics in this palette are the best metallics I've ever used. But the thing about this palette is it has shades I've never seen before. Like, taste buds, oh, bitch. Bitch! Yeah, destroy my property. Yes! Like, I'm doing a look where I should, like, be using, like, a million brushes. I'm using the biggest brush in the whole world to do this one little look. Because that's how little I care. Dumbass, bitch! My mom is gonna watch that back and be like, Emily, don't call yourself that. Bobby Fischer. Where is he? I don't know.
He's dead.
I have very hooded eyes. They're kind of small if you really think about it. Like, in size, they're big, but hooded-wise, they're like, I don't know. I have weird-looking eyes. That's all I gotta say about that. Bye. See you later. Bless you. Bye. So this be the look so far. I'm done. Thought we was done. What's that middle finger? Why did, ugh, girl, I got a beard now. Put that away. So I actually bought another fan brush today. It was a Morphe fan brush. Because my last fan brush looks like this. I don't know how it happened, but it did happen, so. Okay, I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit Bubbly. And so for my nose highlights, because as you can see, I didn't even tap the nose. I like to use, I've been really obsessed with this palette, actually. I bought this entire palette, I think it was like $40 for one shade. And honestly, it's completely worth it. This white shade is like the best highlighter in the world. I would do lipstick, except for lately, I've actually hated, and I mean
hated,
the feeling of lipstick. I find it repulsive. For lip gloss, I really love this Lancome Lip Plumper. And then, you know what? So today I got like a Fix Plus sample, because I've never had Fix Plus. Isn't that crazy? It's so crazy. It smells so good. So that was the look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was entertaining. It was my little chit-chat get ready with me. If I was good at editing, I'd probably put the products I was using above me. I hope you guys have a good night's sleep tonight, because I won't. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!